Hello guys, today I'm going to create an editable grid in Power Apps. So an editable grid is somewhere where you can edit the data directly in the table itself. So I am going to create a grid from this SharePoint list. So first of all, I will insert a gallery to create a grid, and this gallery will have the SharePoint list, which will be editable. So I'm copying the link of this SharePoint list. I am adding a data and I am adding a SharePoint connector. And I'm putting a link to connect. So this is my SharePoint list inventory. I put connect. And now this is connect to my gallery. Now, so I'll put some text input fields. And I have title, quantity, and amount. So I'll put just three fields, two small, one big. Let's fix a bit of looks. This is my gallery, which will be connected to inventory. And then for the default, I'm going to tag this item dot title, which is an item in my gallery. Oops. And same goes here. This item dot quantity, and this item dot amount. Now I need to have some headings for this table, so let's spread it a bit and extend it a bit. Put a label called probably item. This can be quantity, and then another can be amount. Let's distribute them equally through a line. So we have, now let's put a header bar just to give it a feel of a table. So I will put a rectangle here. And then send it back. Now give some color. And then we can give a border to it. Yeah. So yeah, we have a table here. So we might need to add some items to the table, which we can do easily by creating a button. And we can have a form that will add it. But so this is our inventory. Let's make it two column as just one column, right? And have a save here. So this will trigger a new form this one, which is form one, or let's call it form inventory, and put it over here. And then this could be submit. Oops. FRM inventory. So let's add another item that can be one. We have another item here. So now what we can do is make this editable. So what we can do is we can select all these fields, and we can have either whenever these fields change, we can patch the record and have it auto save, or we can have a bulk save feature. So first part is doing the auto save feature, and it's very easy. I'll just patch, and I will patch inventory. I will look up inventory, and then I'll look for an ID that is equal to, so you can see these are the IDs that we are going to compare with. This item dot ID. Now just after this, we need to define what we are patching. So title would be, so we need to know the name of this text input. So let's just change this to txt title. This can be txt quantity, and this can be txt amount. So let's put txt title dot text followed by quantity. Txt qty. Followed by amount, which is txt amount. Put it in the wrong place. This should go on change. So I'm pasting it over here. there might be cases where you would not want when it's changed, but you want something like save all. So whenever you click save all, this needs to save rather than on the change. So for that, what we do is we create a collection, and in that collection we will put all the changes that happens, and then when we click save all, those collections are reflected back to the inventory list. So for that, what I am going to do is collect, let's call it call inventory, and so I am collecting title, amount, quantity. Let's take ID as well. Oops. So whenever this value is changed, the whatever change that happens is added to the collection. But what happens is that it keeps on adding in the inventory collection, but we do not want to do that. We want it to be updated if it's in the same item. So let's put a clear that I'm just putting this to clear out whatever comes into the collection. And it needs to be in all the fields, but it's happening in this one, so I'm pasting it in all. So let's do something. So I'm changing the value, and if we go and check the collection, I have laptops changed. But when I change it again, it needs to update the same record in the collection. But what will happen, it will add the new record in the collection. So what I need to do is, so I need to first check if this item is in collection or not. So in full inventory dot ID. So if this item is in collection, we need to update the collection. So update whole inventory. So we need to update this inventory, and so we need to check the record. We need to match the ID. So this item dot ID equals to, sorry, so we need to check if the ID equals to this item dot ID. We look up the call inventory, and we will update with the same thing that we are creating the collection with. And then if the ID is in collection, we are updating the call inventory. If it's not, we are just adding it to the collection. So this seems fine. Let's format it. Let's close this. Okay, so let's format it now. So now let's clear the collection. Let's see if it's cleared or not. Nothing is here. So I go change and make laptop and desktop. And let's see if the change is reflecting in the collection. Yes. So let's make water bottles. And if I go and check in the collection, it's added here. Now let's go and change the desktop to laptops again. and let's see if it's reflected in the collection or not. Yes. So now we need to update the collection to the record in the SharePoint site. And how we are going to do that is, let's check if there are objects in the collection. If there are not, there's no point in saving. So the name of the collection is called inventory. So when we save all, we count rows. And we check if it's greater than zero or not. And if there are good enough number in the collection, we will save this into the inventory. So inventory is grid in Power Apps. You can add records, you can bulk save, or you can edit one item at a time. So thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video and if you find it helpful, please subscribe to my channel. And if you want to get notified for more videos like this, please click the bell icon. Thank you so much.